from the summertime heat. Take you to Chicago. Why don't we do that and start off with the Windy City and a couple ladies strolling down town here, maybe Lakeside. And where's that, John?
Michigan Avenue.
He knows where it is. Of course, he's a native Chicagoan, my director, John Thayer. And it was a little wet, but it kept temperatures in the mid-70s. 75 was all we had for a high. Look out for some thunderstorms. We'll show you the radar in just a second. In Atlanta, of course, this is a hot spot lately with the Olympics going on. Hundreds of thousands, well, at least thousands of people were downtown, and they were enjoying a cool day. I was one of them early in the day. Temperatures in the 70s for all day long. Started off mainly in the 70s, stayed in there. 79 was the high, and just a little bit of rain, which wasn't bad at all, kept you cool. That's right. Didn't get us too wet, though. And as far as the southeast goes, why is it so cool and wet? Well, we've got a big trough here, and this trough is causing the cool air to be drawn in from Canada. But really, the big story is not so much the cool air from Canada. It is the cloudiness and the showers. You block the sunshine, you block the heating, and therefore you get the coolness. Also, with the jet stream, we're transporting little pieces of energy. Of course, disturbances, we sometimes call them upper-level disturbances. Nothing more than an area of low pressure that's up above the surface, usually 20, 30,000 feet up, you'll find these, or 15,000 feet, and that energy swinging on with the jet stream. Well, we also have a trough, or rather a front in the area, and all this is going in to kind of factor in that rainfall that we've had. Now, we haven't had a lot in Atlanta, and the reason it really hasn't rained a lot here is because the air has been dry. Notice around Atlanta, we've had a lot of moist air. Back in Alabama, Birmingham to Anniston, 2 to 4 inches of rain in some of these areas, and you can see from a radar earlier in the day, there was a lot of rain out this way, but as it moved toward Atlanta, it just fizzled out. A lot of clouds moved in, but not a lot of rain. Here's what's going on right now. We got a few showers out there, and the current radar showing the showers are continuing in parts of the Carolinas, at least North Carolina. Atlanta, you're in the clear and probably be rain-free for a couple of days. Thunderstorms returning perhaps on Wednesday. Savannah seeing some rain and a lot of yachting going on out here, and hopefully some wind. We've had a lack of wind has caused some problems with the Olympic venue there. Showers up in the Carolinas, the Virginias, and also here in the Midwest where we've had severe weather tonight. One watch remains in effect, this tornado watch, for parts of northwest Kansas and eastern Colorado, and the thunderstorms are tending to die down, especially in the Dakotas. The watch here was canceled. There's still a good area of thunderstorms there, at least a more powerful area coming on into South Dakota. Sioux Falls, you got some light rain moving in, and Des Moines, probably just some light showers. Bigger thunderstorms west of Chicago here, moving out toward some of the western suburbs. You can see the rain generally moving to the north here, but a closer inspection, Chicago out toward Rockford, Joliet, LaSalle, we've seen showers and thunderstorms all over this area tonight, even some hail and reports of funnel clouds. That kind of activity hasn't been really reported lately, so I think they have lost some of their punch here as well. And our last stop takes us to St. Louis, where thunderstorms continue to bubble up all through the city here, and we're getting some heavy pockets of rain and maybe some small hail, but then again, there hasn't been a whole lot of severe weather recently. This cell is moving on down to the southeast and should start to hopefully get a little better around St. Louis. Let's check out the rest of the country.
And first of all, we want to take a look at temperatures across the nation. We're at 73 now, New York City 69 in Atlanta, 87 still in Dallas, and it's quite warm still in the west. 86 in LA, 100 the current temperature in Phoenix. And across the country, of course, we've seen that we have a lot of active radars here in the east, but also in the west. Our monsoonal moisture producing scattered showers and thunderstorms here. As we look at our map, you can see where some of the action is here through Washington and Oregon, back to the Four Corners region, and along the tail end of this front, some big storms rumbling through eastern Colorado. But first, into the Pacific Northwest we go, where we have the wet weather here that's been around most of the afternoon and on into the nighttime hours, and we see all that wet weather moving on off to the north. So the monsoonal moisture has made its way all the way into that part of the country. Still some rain and thunderstorm activity moving here through eastern Colorado. Remember, part of this part of the state still under a tornado watch. That means the potential is there for tornadic activity. Finally, we head into the southwest, where even Southern California, a bit of an unusual event, getting wet weather in July, but you've had the soggy conditions here. We'll let you know how long it's going to last coming up in the forecast. Brad?
Well, we've had some heavy rains causing big problems in China. Of course, Typhoon Gloria hit this area, and southern and central China have seen tremendous amounts of rain inundating villages, towns in the nine provinces there. 10 million people reportedly have been affected in one way or another by these floods. The government has mobilized 100,000 troops to help these areas and try to get the water back into the banks of some of the rivers that have succumbed to the flooding, and there could be more problems coming in. 1,500 people so far have lost their lives to this tremendous flooding, and this is the worst thing we could see, is another typhoon headed in the direction of Taiwan. This is Typhoon Herb, and it has winds of 140 miles per hour, but I think the rain at this point has got to be the biggest threat to especially China and certainly Taiwan. Both the rain and the wind will cause problems. So we'll keep you monitored and really watch the system closely as we go through the next couple of days. As we look further into our neck of the woods, we're looking at Mexico with a problem. This is now a tropical depression. Remember, we used to have a hurricane. It went into Nicaragua's Hurricane Cesar. I almost lost that. Cesar kind of went kaput, and now it has reborn itself in the Pacific Ocean as a tropical depression. It likely will become a tropical storm, and that tropical storm would be named Douglas, and that could be as early as Monday morning and affecting areas around Acapulco. We'll have the latest and complete tropical update in about 10 minutes, but first, Kristina has the latest in your forecast.
And we head into Monday morning. An area of low pressure still around here, anchored over the Great Lakes region. That means rain and thunderstorms again here. It's going to be a bit cool, it's going to be cloudy, and it's going to be wet. Milwaukee, Detroit, Cleveland, I'll look for soggy conditions, as well as on into Philadelphia. To the south, a bit of scattered activity, and through the west, a little bit of scattered action too, becoming more widespread during the day as we have that moisture coming on in, the heating of the afternoon sparking the showers and thunderstorms. Look for big storms in this region too, south of our trough. We think the heaviest amounts of rain will be in a couple of areas here, half an inch to an inch for these storms in Colorado and on into Kansas, and with the area of low pressure in the Great Lakes region. Low temperatures, 60s and 70s overnight for most folks. We'll have some hot temperatures across the south and in the west as we have the big ridge of high pressure here, the trough in the east. So remember, 60s and 70s for highs for the Great Lakes region. We'll eventually see some of those cooler temperatures sliding on into the southeast. So Atlanta, Birmingham, look for highs only in the 80s for Wednesday. That's going to be a little bit of welcome relief from the hot temperatures. The 80s don't sound so bad, but the 90s continuing in the west and along the Gulf Coast. Rain and thunderstorms along our frontal boundary here from the northeast back to the Plain States. We'll see monsoonal moisture continuing in the west. Isolated thunderstorms possible here throughout the forecast. Our front sliding on southward and eastward for your Wednesday. So from southern New England back to Texas, rain and thunderstorms will be around. Thursday, once again, the eastern seaboard getting the bulk of the activity. And here's what you can expect for Friday.
Looks like there could be some rain in the Olympic City next couple days.
That's a possibility, but at least it's going to be a little cooler, so that's something to be thankful for.
Pretty good trade-off, yeah. I guess. Well, stay tuned. We've got your local weather coming up and also the latest on the tropics in detail in about 10 minutes.
Okay, if we just follow I'm sure we're...
You're lost, aren't you?
We're lost.
Do you have any idea where we're going?
Yeah, we're right. It wasn't a highway, it was a ketchup stain.
Where are more and more people taking their rugged off-road vehicles these days?
We're close. This is looking real good. We're here.
The Audi A6 Quattro. With Quattro all-wheel drive and all the comforts of a German luxury car, it's where more and more 4x4 owners are heading every day.
Test drive an Audi today. For the nearest dealer, call 1-800-4-AUDI. This is your local forecast. Information you can plan on, because now we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
from the Weather Channel. A storm chaser knows the risk.
This is a potentially dangerous weather situation.
Respects the power.
It's frightening. I mean, there's just no other word to put it in.
Yet is compelled to follow.
For me, chasing is the ultimate adventure.
The chase is on.
A tornado on the ground.
Call 1-800-626-9477 now and order the new home video, Storm Chaser, Warren Fadley, available only from the Weather Channel. Pursue monster storms with Warren Fadley, one of the world's foremost storm chasers.
I never know what I'm going to see.
It is directly overhead.
Witness stunning new footage and photographs from the Storm Chaser's personal archives, never before seen until now. This isn't Hollywood. It's the real thing, and only the Weather Channel can bring it to you. To order your home video, Storm Chaser, Warren Fadley, call 1-800-626-9477 or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $3.95 shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Order now.
Time now for a look at international weather. First, a check of high temperatures Sunday. A nice temperature for London, up to 75 degrees, 83 in Paris, and another hot day in Spain, Madrid, 88, and Seville, a scorcher at 99 degrees. If your travel plans take you to Europe on Tuesday, you'll find a little bit of unsettled weather with an area of low pressure in the east. Showers and thunderstorms possible here, and a front approaching the British Isles could keep things a little on the soggy side. Temperatures 70s and 80s for most areas, but central and southern Spain, once again, high temperatures in the 90s and 100s. In Athens, look for partly cloudy skies, a high in the low 90s. Increasing clouds in Brussels and in London with that approaching front. Highs there in the low 70s. Mostly sunny in Madrid, a high in the low 90s. Mostly sunny as well in Frankfurt. And in Paris, expect partly cloudy skies with a high temperature near 80 degrees. And stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll head back to the U.S. and check out your Bowden Beach report.
Where do smart players go? Players Club International. The experts who will show you how to have fun the smart way. Las Vegas, Atlantic City, the Caribbean. Players Club members are guaranteed to always save up to 60% on rooms, food and drinks, and even shows. Or maybe you just want to relax and play the course. Players members receive up to 50% savings at over 1,000 golf courses. And you can even use your card for airlines, car rentals, and cruises. Or for that smart getaway, save up to 50% off at over 8,000 hotels worldwide. Any way you want to play, the experts at Players Club can take care of you today. 800-738-5577. Call now for free information with absolutely no cost, no obligation on how you can play the smart way. Plus, new members receive a free Players Preferred package with over $150 in free money and comps, and your free video, the Casino Survival Kit.
It's time now for the Bowden Beach Report, and if your plans take you out tomorrow to the beach or to the lake, or if you're just going to enjoy some time outdoors, you are going to want to protect your skin. Our suncast shows that a lot of the country in the red and orange zone, that means it's not going to take very long at all to burn. So again, put on plenty of sunscreen and keep in mind that in these areas it's going to be very, very warm as well. So if you're going to spend much time outdoors, take frequent breaks, drink plenty of water, wear lightweight, light-colored clothing, and if you can, just stay indoors in the air conditioning. Water temperatures off the northeast coast ranging from the low 60s to the low 70s. Your winds will generally be 5 to 15 miles per hour with a few exceptions. 82 the water temperature for Panama City, 88 Tampa, 85 the Keys, and 84 for Miami. And along the west coast, water temperatures here generally in the 50s, except for San Diego, where the water temperature will be 66 degrees. Well, stay tuned. Coming up next, we'll update the tropics.
Is your child protected for the future? Gerber, the baby people you've known since you were an infant, offers you a way to help with that protection through their Grow Up Plan for Children. It's a $5,000 cash value insurance program that costs less than 11 cents a day. At age 21, that protection doubles to $10,000 with absolutely no increase in premiums. In addition to automatically doubling at age 21, the plan also guarantees the right to $50,000 of insurance by age 28, regardless of health or occupation. So call now for your free information packet. Any healthy child 12 and under is eligible to apply. No medical examination is necessary. Simply answer a few questions. As a special feature, your first month's premium is $1. The Gerber Life Grow Up Plan.
To show you care, call now. Call 1-800-976-8899. The information package is free. There is no obligation. This offer is available to parents and grandparents only. That number again is 1-800-976-8899.
Weather. Every day it moves and changes. There's something happening somewhere, and we bring you all of it in WeatherScope, the day's top weather stories, with live on-the-scene reports during major breaking events, up-to-the-minute forecast for the nation and specific regions, and fascinating insight that lets you understand exactly what's happening and why. WeatherScope. It's all the weather you want, every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
Get weather forecasts for over 900 cities nationwide any time of day on the Weather Channel website, www.weather.com. No place on earth has better weather.
Because you asked for it, the Psychic Solution is back on the road, giving people the chance to find out just how exceptional their psychics really are.
She hit the nail right on the head. She got me. She definitely got me.
She helped me out and made a true believer on me.
She said that a right one will stick around. He'll prove his love to me, and he's going to be the one for me, so I'm happy.
And I just felt like she was my best friend, you know, or a family member. She knew things about me than only they would know.
I'm adopted, and she was able to tell me that, and that really blew me away.
Based on the things that she told me, it felt like she actually grew up with me.
Will you recommend this to your friends?
My friends, definitely, because I'm hard to convince, and if I'm convinced, my friends will be also.
They might be skeptical at first, but a phone call is all it's going to take, and then they'll change their minds, believe me.
The Psychic Solution wants you to speak to these same real psychics, so call for your free sample reading now.
Try it now. Call 1-800-987-9667.
This is your local forecast, information you can plan on, because now we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
Has better weather. Forecasts from the Weather Channel are also available from the following.
Time now for our tropical update, and we want to start out first of all with our newest tropical depression, Tropical Depression 7E. Now, this is actually what's left of Cesar. Cesar was, again, the hurricane that moved through Nicaragua. Well, it has now reemerged off of the Pacific coast, and when that happens, it gets an entirely new name, and we now have a tropical depression here. It has moved out over the land, over the open water now, and that is allowing it to re-strengthen. Now what we see is the center of the tropical depression at 13 north, 90.6 west. That puts it about 160 miles southeast of the Mexican-Guatemala border, and maximum sustained winds 35 miles per hour. It's moving off to the west at 21 miles per hour. Now again, because we do think that there is a possibility that it will strengthen, and the Mexican government has issued a tropical storm watch from Acapulco back to Puerto Madero. So again, tropical storm watch is in effect for this region. Let's take a look at our satellite view, and you can see what happens. Again, it moved through the Caribbean, it moved through Nicaragua, producing again a lot of windy conditions and wet weather certainly. Now it's moved back over the Pacific. It's got those warm waters to help it regenerate, and now it is a tropical depression. If it does become a tropical storm, it will be named Douglas. It will have a new name, no longer Cesar. A new name now that it's in the eastern Pacific. And it looks like it does have the potential to certainly bring a lot of wet weather to the Mexican coast, as well as some very windy conditions. We'll continue to monitor the track of this tropical depression now and let you know what happens with it. But again, you can see it getting more well organized here. The darker reds indicating where the heavier convection is, the heavier rain. And we'll continue to monitor this situation. Really interesting what's going on with this. And certainly Mexico could be in for some pretty rough weather associated with this. What else is going on in the tropics? Well, we've got another wave that we're watching as it moves through Puerto Rico and Hispaniola, producing some wet conditions there. Again, it is a tropical wave, just moving on off to the west. And what we want to do is focus in on this region and see what we have to contend with here. Of course, earlier today, it looked like it was beginning to become somewhat organized. It looked like it may be moving into an area that was sort of favorable for development. Now it's looking like the conditions are not quite as favorable. However, we're going to continue to watch the situation. We're going to continue to watch the wave, but not looking as promising as it did a little earlier this afternoon. But again, you can get the latest details on this area here at the Weather Channel, so stay tuned. As we head off the west coast of Africa, a couple of waves here, one moving out over the waters and yet another moving right on off the coast. And it's time of year when we focus our attention on this area as well. You know, earlier in the summer, we would tend to look farther back towards the Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico, but now's the time when we focus on this region. You can see those waves coming right on off, and we'll continue to watch them as they march on off to the west. And if anything develops with these, we'll let you know about that too. Next, we head out to the western Pacific, where we have Typhoon Herb here, and it is headed towards Taiwan and China. That's bad news, as you've just had certainly some very terrible flooding problems here with the last typhoon. Well, yet another is headed this way, and that's bad news. A Herb packing 140 mile per hour winds, and again, it's going to drop some heavy amounts of rain, Taiwan, and probably on into China as well. So not such good news here. Well, what's going on a little closer to home? We've got an area of low pressure here over the Great Lakes region. Rain and thunderstorms here, and this low is not going to move a great deal as we head into tomorrow. We also have some wet weather here to the west, our monsoonal moisture coming in, and scattered showers and thunderstorms have been around. Some of these have been packing quite a punch. You can find slick roadways in any of these areas across the country. The threat for severe weather, though, here in the Plain States, and we do have a watch to tell you about, a severe thunderstorm watch that includes much of Kansas. That means the potential is there for strong, gusty, damaging winds, large hail, and heavy amounts of rain. Well, that's a look at our current weather. Let's see what the forecast holds. On into Monday morning we go. Again, this area of low pressure, not moving very much. Rain and thunderstorms here. Look out in Milwaukee, Detroit, Cleveland. It's going to be a soggy, sort of murky day tomorrow. Not getting very warm. Temperatures in the 60s and 70s for high, so it's going to be a bit cool, a bit soggy. The wet weather all the way back into maybe Philadelphia, maybe Trenton getting some wet weather too. And in the west, we'll have some more active weather on into the afternoon hour. Scattered showers and thunderstorms here with the monsoonal moisture. And then ahead of this trough, thunderstorms through Kansas and Missouri. Here's where we think the heaviest amounts of rain will be, half an inch to an inch here with the storms through the Plain States and with our area of low pressure here to the Great Lakes region. Temperatures overnight, 60s and 70s for most areas. High temperatures, well, it's going to be cool. Remember here, 60s for northern Wisconsin and northern lower Michigan, 90s for the southeast, and also in the west under that big ridge of high pressure. Well, stay tuned. We'll update your travel conditions next.
Why do I keep feeling like this? Won't I get over it? I can't take this anymore. What is it? And what does it mean?
Are you troubled by feelings you can't explain? The answer is just a phone call away.
The future, what does it hold for you? Will you do the right thing? Will you make the right choice? Hello, sweet spirits. I'm Kenny Kingston. The psychics on my hotline are there to help you take control of your destiny.
I never thought about calling a psychic before, but I really needed some help in making a big decision. And that's why I called Kenny's psychic hotline. He helped me so much.
If you really want to make changes in your life, call Kenny's psychic hotline, because they give you the information that you really need.
All it takes is one phone call to the Kenny Kingston psychic hotline.
My psychics are there to help you make your wishes and your dreams become a reality. Don't wait, please. Make that telephone call now.
WeatherScope. It's all the weather you want. Every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
Well, here's our travel trouble spot, an area of low pressure keeping things a bit unsettled here. We've got rain and thunderstorms, and it looks like they're going to be around on into tomorrow as well through Wisconsin and Michigan, back towards Illinois and Indiana. Look out for slick roadways in any of these areas. And you can also see some storms, too, especially here into Kansas, where you could have some potentially rough weather. Other areas with a chance for soggy conditions here along the East Coast, back into the Four Corners region with scattered showers and thunderstorms still rumbling here. But we're concerned with the threat of severe weather through the Plain States, through Nebraska, on into the Dakotas, but strong storms anywhere from around Chicago back towards maybe Phoenix and on into Southern California. We do have one watch to tell you about, a severe thunderstorm watch for parts of Kansas. Strong gusty winds, hail, heavy rain, all possible here. And look out for foggy conditions that could certainly reduce your visibilities in these regions. And stay tuned. We'll have your hometown forecast coming up next.
At Michelin, we believe a tire that's just good in the rain isn't good enough. Introducing the Michelin X1 with a 6-year unlimited mileage tread life warranty. It gives you better wet traction than any rain tire and Michelin confidence in any driving condition. It has to, because the way we see it, you don't just cover a lot of miles, you cover a lot of weather. The Michelin X1.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Now your local forecast, and stay tuned. An in-depth look at weather in the West, Alaska, and Hawaii is next in the Pacific Update.
Good morning to you, and thanks for joining us here at the Weather Channel. I'm Janine Diadamo, and my technical director this hour is Greg Gentile. Together, we'll be telling you a lot of things. First of all, about a very active night in the tropics, and also A very active but not a very summer-like pattern going on in the U.S. right now. Let's show you some heavy rains from Typhoon Gloria. This is last week, and that's causing massive flooding today in South and Central China. A swollen river has inundated entire villages and towns across 9 provinces. 10 million people have been affected, many driven from their homes. The government has mobilized 100,000 troops to shore up bulging riverbanks. To date, 1,500 people have lost their lives to surging floodwaters or by succumbing to disease. The casualty count is expected to rise even more before the flood subsides. So I want to show you the tropics right now because that was Typhoon Gloria, which passed generally right through northern portions of the Philippines a few days ago. Now you're looking at Typhoon Herb, and this one a lot stronger than Typhoon Gloria ever was. Right now, the maximum sustained winds are up to 140 miles an hour. And check out the outflow here. This thing is taking up a lot of space. It's in a massive engine of energy as it races off to the west. Again, to be a super typhoon here in the western Pacific, it must reach a threshold of 150 miles an hour. It has not done that, and we're hoping that the typhoon will weaken a little bit. This is the island of Taiwan. It almost looks like a leaf, I sometimes think, right here. It looks like right now with the current forecast track, this typhoon is going to hit Taiwan dead on. And with the mountains here, this could cause a lot of problems. Many deaths are possible because of this. So certainly we'll be keeping you updated on Typhoon Herb. Another problem down the road a piece, once it moves into mainland China, you just saw the flooding and 1,500 people were killed by a weaker typhoon. I don't want to know what's going to happen with this one, but we'll keep you updated. A little bit closer to home, we have another depression. Now, this might look familiar to you. This is the remnants of Hurricane Cesar. But what happens is when a hurricane goes from the Atlantic into, or rather the Atlantic Basin, that's the Caribbean, into the Pacific, it changes names. And as it crashed on into the Mosquito Coast right here in Nicaragua near Bluefields, it weakened because of the mountains. It became just a tropical low. But then when it emerged in the warmer waters here in the Pacific, it became a tropical depression. As of 11 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time, it has been upgraded to Tropical Depression 7E. If it does strengthen and become a tropical storm, which it is forecast to do, it will be named Tropical Storm Douglas. Kristina was the other one, and then we had Douglas, if this does develop. Right now, wind speed up to 35 miles an hour, 160 miles southeast of the Mexican-Guatemala border, which is right here. And there are some watches out, tropical storm watches out from Acapulco, Mexico to Puerto Madero. I can't read that very well. Madero, that's what it is. So tropical storm watches out in effect for some very popular vacation resorts. So unfortunately causing some problems through this area. Here it is for you on the satellite picture. Again, looking pretty well organized, doesn't it? It almost looks like a tropical storm as far as its organization and its form. And again, we are expecting it to strengthen and possibly be called a tropical storm sometime in the next 12 to 24 hours. And still, the rainfall affecting southern Mexico into Guatemala and even as far south as Costa Rica right here, so still causing problems. In the Caribbean, we have one more thing to show you. This is a tropical wave. It had looked pretty strong, and it seems like it will be moving into an area that might be favorable for it to develop. But right now, we started to see the pressures rising a little bit around it, which is not giving us an indication that, at least in the immediate future, it's going to strengthen, but it does bear watching over the next several days. Let's check on the forecast for the Pacific. High Sunday, look this way. Seattle, 83 degrees. Medford, 87. And where it's been real hot in Phoenix, 106, no big changes through this area. Well, the current map, again, showing us our rainfall, monsoonal moisture working its way into the Pacific Northwest, even into Northern California. And we're going to watch the temperatures really heating up. Not right now, of course, getting to the evening hours at Medford's 80 degrees right now, further to the north in Seattle at 78. Take you further to the south, still nice and cool around San Francisco with your offshore wind. 58 degrees around the Bay Area. Inland around Marysville, still hot in the valleys, 100 degrees. And with the thunderstorms you had earlier in San Bernardino County, also for the San Bernardino Mountains, we had some localized flooding. 100 degrees is still the temperature in Palm Springs. Here's a look at the earthquake activity report. The blue dot there indicating a 2.7 in magnitude, that hurricane in Ontario, California, and a 3.2 on the Saffir-Simpson scale in 29 Palms, California. None were reported around the San Francisco Bay Area, and no earthquakes were reported in the Northwest either. However, in Alaska, we did have a earthquake reported today. It was just a tremor, 2.9, near Anchorage, Alaska. And certainly we'll give you this report each night and let you know of any earthquakes, any kind of earthquake activity whatsoever we'll put up for you. The current map showing us an area of low pressure pretty vigorous. This is going to be a major player in the forecast over the next 5 days. The trough of low pressure not going anywhere. That means cool weather, but very unsettled weather from the Great Lakes all the way down into the Tennessee Valley. Will cold or cool weather get all the way down to Atlanta, Georgia for the end of the Olympic Games? We've got that answer coming up next in the 5-Day Business Planner. Gene will join us in just a few moments, and he'll tell us lots of interesting things. We've also got hot weather to tell you about in the Northwest with a ridge of high pressure in place. Stay with us.
Was I upset? Very. But I handled my thinning hair in a mature fashion. I put a hat on my head, ran to my sister and said, tell me this is not happening. She said some women do lose their hair, just like Aunt Beth. But now there's Rogaine. It goes to the root of your hair and for some people gets it to grow. And now you don't need a prescription to get it, so go get it. Rogaine's starting to work, and I'm thinking before long, I can get rid of all these hats. Rogaine, medically proven to regrow hair.
Information you can plan on, because now we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
Too many bills, not enough money. Every month we're deeper in debt.
Which is larger, your ambition or your income? Step up to a career in electronics. The Cleveland Institute of Electronics, CIE, is for men and women with ambition to land high-paying jobs, gain promotions, and make careers. Through CIE's independent study, learn from among the world's most highly regarded electronics specialists. In the U.S. and in 70 nations, more than 100,000 CIE graduates are earning top incomes in electronics. Approved by the Department of Veterans Affairs, CIE is fully accredited and licensed in all 50 states. If you have an intense desire to make it, call toll-free 1-800-467-9177 and receive your free catalog. Secure your future in electronics.
That's the last of the bills, and there's money in the bank.
Why don't we get away for a long weekend?
60 meteorologists, advanced weather technology. Stay ahead of the storm. Tropical updates 50 minutes past every hour on the Weather Channel. Brought to you by the Home Depot.
It's now time for the Traveler's Update. Should you be doing some traveling in parts of the upper Midwest, you could run into some problems. Some scattered heavy showers in parts of central Illinois and central Iowa right now. Around the rest of the country, rainy travel, at least widely scattered over parts of the southwest. And towards morning, some increase in the wet roadways around Philadelphia and Baltimore and Washington. Severe weather, still a possibility in parts of Nebraska, extreme southern Nebraska, that is, and a good part of Kansas. As a matter of fact, we still have a severe thunderstorm watch in effect for a good chunk of central Kansas. There's some very heavy thunderstorms in western and north central Kansas at this time. Watch out for that fog. Could reduce your visibilities to under a half a mile, even near zero at times, from Des Moines to St. Louis to Kansas City to Knoxville, up to near Charleston, West Virginia. So if you're out and about tomorrow morning, you might want to plan your trip to work accordingly. Florida, it's coming up next. Some cities in Florida have been having record-breaking heat, other cities record-breaking cold temperatures. We'll tell you which cities those are next in your Florida forecast.
If you or anyone you love has ever suffered from low back pain, poor circulation, minor arthritic-like pain, or just poor sleep, you owe it to yourself to call for this free 50-minute video with health tips from Dr. Nagler and this free Celebrity Choice adjustable bed catalog. Dr. Nagler, Chief of Physical Medicine at Cornell University Medical Center, will share his valuable health tips on how to live a long and healthy life. And you'll hear Celebrity Choice adjustable bed owners tell how their bed helps relieve many aches and pains that would just never go away. And you'll learn the advantages adjustable beds have over flat, air, and water beds, and all in the privacy of your home with absolutely no high pressure. So call for your free 50-minute video with health tips from Dr. Nagler. The video and your Celebrity Choice catalog are free if you call right now.
Call 1-800-492-8800. No purchase is necessary. Get your free video and catalog. Call 1-800-492-8800.
Right now, the weather is changing. What's here today can be gone tomorrow. Because we know you need to plan and prepare, we dedicate a special team to forecasting the outlook for the days ahead. So you know what to expect. Watch our 5-day planner, 20 minutes after every hour on the Weather Channel. No place on Earth has better weather.
It's now time for the Florida forecast. Second day in a row, Orlando, you had a record low temperature yesterday at 71. This morning, you had another record low at 68 degrees, unusually cool. Some clear sky, I guess lots of clear skies, high pressure around, allowing the warm air during the day to escape into space. So that's why it's been a little bit on the cool side. Daytona Beach, a record low of 68. Now yesterday, not only did you have a record low, you had a record high temperature in Orlando. That wasn't the case today, but Tampa, you wouldn't let it go by for a whole day without having some record in Florida. So Tampa raised their hand and said, we're going to have a record high of 98 degrees today. Lots of sunny weather in Florida, except the peninsula right now. A few clouds around the panhandle, I should say. The peninsula is definitely clear. If you live in Tampa or Miami or West Palm, look up in the sky. You see a beautiful, almost full moon and lots of stars tonight. If you're going to be out and about tomorrow, make sure you splash on that sunscreen to protect your delicate, precious skin from those harsh ultraviolet rays. 88 degrees, the water temperature in Clearwater, warming up to 94 tomorrow, Fort Myers at 93. An update on the hot weather and your 5-day outlook next.
Some people clean their dentures in the daytime, but if you soak at night, get new Polident Overnight. Its unique enzyme formula cleans and whitens better than daytime soaks. New Polident Overnight, next to fast-acting 5-minute Polident.
Look for a money-saving coupon for Double Action Polident in your Sunday paper.
It's bigger than its predecessors, more powerful. And yet, beneath its tough exterior, it's also more accommodating and approachable. Plus, it's available in two-wheel or four-wheel drive. Introducing the all-new 4Runner. Sophisticated, refined, fearless.
Get weather forecasts for over 900 cities nationwide any time of day on the Weather Channel website, www.weather.com. No place on earth has better weather.
Because you asked for it, the Psychic Solution is back on the road, giving people the chance to find out just how exceptional their psychics really are.
She hit the nail right on the head. She got me. She definitely got me.
She helped me out and made a true believer out of me.
She said that a right one will stick around. He'll prove his love to me, and he's going to be the one for me, so I'm happy.
And I just felt like she was my best friend, you know, or a family member. She knew things about me than only they would know.
I'm adopted, and she was able to tell me that. And that really blew me away.
Based on the things that she told me, it felt like she actually grew up with me.
Will you recommend this to your friends?
My friends, definitely, because I'm hard to convince. And if I'm convinced, my friends will be also.
They might be skeptical at first, but a phone call is all it's going to take. And then they'll change their minds, believe me.
The Psychic Solution wants you to speak to these same real psychics. So call for your free sample reading now.
Call now, 1-800-526-4398.
This is your local forecast, and stay tuned. The National Outlook is just ahead in our five-day planner. Place on earth has better weather.
All right, thanks for joining us, folks. It's time now for the five-day business planner. It's 20 past the hour, and got news for you. Soggy conditions in the east are in almost all of the next 5 days. All right, you're gonna see it. What's causing it? Elements for the rain. Sunday, this was the upper air pattern, and generally we show you this pattern even though this was Sunday's because it's pretty much going to stay like this. The jet stream unusually far to the south. You know, this time of the year, cold air doesn't typically make its way all the way south to the Gulf Coast because, first of all, the sun angle is so high in the sky, and also The sun has moved at an angle such that it's right at about 30 degrees north at the Tropic of Cancer. So typically the warm air is pushing its way further to the north. It's like a big balancing act. You know, the seasons are. One season, the polar jet stream comes down and brings the cooler air. The next, it goes right back up where it came from. So the Earth is constantly trying to balance itself out, and that's a lot of what you see in the day-to-day differences in the weather. But getting back to the elements for rain here before I get on a different subject completely and go off track, which I'm known to do, we do have several disturbances aloft. What are disturbances aloft? We call them short waves or vorticity. Generally, it's cold air aloft sometimes that allows that air to rise. You get the real lifting of the air, and that's what causes the condensation, the clouds to form, and the clouds to precipitate that rain all the way down to the earth, and some areas getting some pretty heavy rains. We do have a stationary frontal boundary right through this area. Behind the front, you're not going to notice a huge difference in temperatures, but you are going to notice a very big difference in the dew points, which is a measurement of how wet the atmosphere is, how much moisture is in the atmosphere. And the 70-degree dew point line goes like this, through around Macon, Georgia, Atlanta to the north of it. So your dew points were below 70 today in Atlanta. It felt a lot more dry outside, a lot more comfortable. And there's a lot of low-level moisture to go around from portions of Missouri, Florida, throughout the Carolinas. So that's the ingredients for the rain. That's exactly what we've had. However, Monday morning, the front is going to begin to lift a little bit further to the north. We find the front lifting towards the northeast, bringing the showers and thunderstorms with it. But this is a pretty odd occurrence as well, because you're going to find by the afternoon we've got a warm front here, the warm air pushing on into the cooler, drier air, and that's causing the overrunning. In other words, the air is going above the denser, drier air, and all that rain's coming on down. So overrunning moisture, that's something like we would see in September or even into the spring, not usually seen in the summer. So pretty odd pattern we've got going on here. And we're looking at more rains throughout the Great Lakes. Also, with that cluster of thunderstorms developing where we have a severe thunderstorm watch out in Kansas now, anywhere from a half of an inch to an inch of rain. And we do believe by tomorrow the rainfall in Southern California will shut off, which is good news because we've had problems with flooding through this area in the evening hours. Overnight lows dipping into the 40s around Boulder, Colorado, and in some of the ski resorts, temperatures really are dropping. Meanwhile, 60s all the way on up to Madison and Milwaukee, Wisconsin. But we're going to keep it real cool. Remember the trough, the jet stream further to the south than normal, so you're going to find the air very cool over the next 5 days, including Tuesday, Wednesday, the 70s all the way down to Kansas City and towards Bluefield, West Virginia. And of course, Pittsburgh and New York staying in the 70s, which is a good 5 degrees below, 10 degrees below normal for this time of the year. And watch what happens even by Friday. 80s are all the way to the Gulf Coast. Meanwhile, if you have interest in the West, you've been watching the temperature soaring here, as I pointed out the last 5 days. With a ridge of high pressure in place, temperatures will be in the 90s, even 100s through the valleys of California. How about the rain? You could follow the front, pick it out yourself. It's in the very dark green colors. That's where we're going to find the front, slowly pushing to the south. And Florida looks like you have a pretty good shot at getting some rain through the middle parts and end of the week. And the Atlantic seaboard, I'm sure you're going to have plenty of it to make you sick of it. In D.C. and Baltimore, New York, we're going to find, even if you don't get rain every day, you're going to find that the temperatures are cut down, and also you will be looking at some real cloudy, murky, and gray weather. Well, planning a trip to Alaska or to Hawaii, some cool temperatures. We'll tell you more about it coming up.
You've spent your entire life sleeping in an old-fashioned flat bed, but now you have the opportunity.
Discover the mysteries of weather with fascinating products from the Weather Channel. CD-ROMs, videos, books, calendars, and more. To receive your free catalog, call 1-800-250-5979 today.
Now, the Weather Channel can give you weather now on the Internet as a service of Pathfinder. Forecasts at your fingertips. Just a click away on the World Wide Web when you get weather now from the Weather Channel. Now available on Pathfinder at pathfinder.com.
Local forecast. Information you can plan on, because now we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
Is your child protected for the future? Gerber, the baby people you've known since you were an infant, offers you a way to help with that protection through their Grow Up Plan for Children. It's a $5,000 cash value insurance program that costs less than 11 cents a day. At age 21, that protection doubles to $10,000 with absolutely no increase in premiums. In addition to automatically doubling at age 21, the plan also guarantees the right to $50,000 of insurance by age 28, regardless of health or occupation. So call now for your free information packet. Any healthy child 12 and under is eligible to apply. No medical examination is necessary. Simply answer a few questions. As a special feature, your first month's premium is $1. The Gerber Life Grow Up Plan.
To show you care, call now. Call 1-800-976-8899. The information package is free. There is no obligation. This offer is available to parents and grandparents only. That number again is 1-800-976-8899.
WeatherScope. It's all the weather you want. Every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
All right, folks, let's take a trip to Europe and starting you out with the forecast for Tuesday, midday hours. And you notice another frontal system moving on into Ireland and into England, and I'm telling you, we're going to get some showers around Dublin and Shannon and also around Scotland. London, it'll be a little bit before you get the showers, but of course the clouds are coming in advance of that system. One low pressure system working its way into Eastern Europe. Ukraine getting pretty wet. Looks like some of the shores of the Black Sea getting a few showers as well. But high pressure behind our front is going to mean temperatures warming around Italy into the 80s, and we're going to find some 90s and 100s once again in Spain after Monday with temperatures in the 90s. Athens looks this way, lower 90s, partly cloudy skies, increasing cloudiness. Oh, sorry, we spelled that wrong. Temperature in the lower 70s. Mostly sunny skies in Madrid, temperature in the lower 90s for your Tuesday, and Rome will be partly cloudy. Well, some showers creeping on up towards D.C. and eventually maybe to New York.
You've spent your entire life sleeping in an old-fashioned flat bed, but now you have the opportunity to find out about a better, healthier way to relax and sleep. Get this free information kit about Craftmatic adjustable beds. Call toll-free and a helpful operator will mail you a free Craftmatic adjustable bed catalog and this special rebate certificate. It's worth $200 off any Craftmatic Model 1 adjustable bed. Why is Craftmatic making this rebate offer? It's our way of saying thanks for taking the time to find out about Craftmatic. There is, of course, absolutely no obligation for calling toll-free and requesting this helpful information kit. So if you have any interest in adjustable beds, pick up your phone and call now.
Call toll-free 1-800-901-9393. That's 1-800-901-9393 toll-free. 1-800-901-9393.
Weather. Every day it moves and changes. There's something happening somewhere, and we bring you all of it in WeatherScope, the day's top weather stories, with live on-the-scene reports during major breaking events, up-to-the-minute forecast for the nation and specific regions, and fascinating insight that lets you understand exactly what's happening and why. WeatherScope. It's all the weather you want, every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
Well, still some active radar sites this evening. One very active site, of course, in Virginia, moving into Maryland. Looks like some pretty heavy rains moving into the state of Maryland, to D.C., to Baltimore. Here it comes. Philadelphia, you're in the target zone. And New York, eventually, you're going to need the umbrellas. Probably by tomorrow night or the afternoon hours, late afternoon, the showers will be on the increase. Certainly, the clouds are lowering and thickening around the New York City metro area. Further to the west, we do have some pretty strong thunderstorms just west of Chicago. The western suburbs getting the thunder and lightning as we speak, and no severe thunderstorm warnings are out for these cells, but some of them look pretty intense, especially these heading on towards the Indiana border, so keep an eye on those. Also, we have one lone severe thunderstorm watch left over after the plethora of them earlier. Kansas until 6 a.m. Central Daylight Time. We do have some strong storms moving their way eastward towards Russell, mostly in rural areas right now. Brand new update on Tropical Depression 7. Stay with us.
When the game starts this early, you need real coffee. Folgers Coffee Singles, real mountain-grown coffee in a real coffee filter for one freshly brewed cup. Folgers Coffee Singles, because real coffee makes real good mornings.
Okay, if we just follow the, I'm sure we're...
You're lost, aren't you?
We're lost.
Do you have any idea where we're going?
Yeah, we're right. It wasn't a highway, it was a ketchup stain.
Where are more and more people taking their rugged off-road vehicles these days?
This is looking real good. We're here.
The Audi A6 Quattro. With Quattro all-wheel drive and all the comforts of a German luxury car, it's where more and more 4x4 owners are heading every day.
Test drive an Audi today. For the nearest dealer, call 1-800-4-AUDI.
Some people clean their dentures in the daytime. But if you soak at night, get new Polident Overnight. Its unique enzyme formula cleans and whitens better than daytime soaks. New Polident Overnight. Next to fast-acting 5-minute Polident.
Look for a money-saving coupon for a double-action Polident in your Sunday paper.
Right now, the weather is changing. What's here today can be gone tomorrow. Because we know you need to plan and prepare, we dedicate a special team to forecasting the outlook for the days ahead. So you know what to expect. Watch our 5-day planner, 20 minutes after every hour on the Weather Channel. No place on Earth has better weather.
Get weather forecasts for over 900 cities nationwide any time of day on the Weather Channel website, www.weather.com. No place on Earth has better weather.
Property owners looking for a better way to maintain the overgrown off-lawn areas on your property? Call toll-free for details on the amazing Troy-Built Sickle Bar Mower, including this free information package and how you can use a brand new Sickle Bar on your own property free till 1997. The Troy-Built Sickle Bar Mower charges through tough, wiry field grass, over rugged, overgrown hillsides, around ponds, along fence lines, even standing saplings are no match for the scissor action Troy-Built Sickle Bar Mower. And with a big 42-inch cutting blade and brake through power steering, you'll make quick work of big off-lawn mowing jobs. Plus, right now, you can use a brand new Sickle Bar mower free till 1997, with no money down and no payments till next year. For all the exciting details, call for your free information package today.
For details on the amazing Sickle Bar mower, including how to have a Sickle Bar mower delivered to your home with no money down and no payments till 1997, call toll-free 1-800-889-4700. That's 1-800-889-4700. Call now.
This is your local forecast. Information you can plan on, because now we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
Thank you.
Weather Channel. No place on earth has better weather.
Lots to talk about tonight in the tropics. We have a major typhoon in the Pacific Ocean. We also have the latest information on Tropical Depression 7E. 24 hours ago, this was Hurricane Cesar. Just 24 hours ago, it moved on to the coast of Nicaragua, right about here north of Blue Fields, with winds around 38 to 40 miles per hour, stronger winds to the north of the storm. Heavy rains have been inundating much of Central America, Nicaragua, over much of the day today. Again, you can read the numbers for yourself as of 8 o'clock Pacific time. Here are the latest numbers as of 11 o'clock. 13.1 north, so it's moved about a tenth of a degree to the north. 91.7 west, so it's moved, let's see, about a degree to the west, so it's moving a little bit more west than north, as expected. Wind still 35 miles an hour, still moving west at 21. It's now about 170 kilometers south-southeast of Mexico-Guatemalan border. And as it says here in this latest statement, it is likely to become a tropical storm very soon. And we're pretty sure here the next advisory, can't guarantee it, but it looks like the next advisory in about 3 hours, this will be upgraded to a tropical storm. And it will be named Douglas. No more Cesar. Once it gets out of the Caribbean and it moves into the Pacific, we then change the name, or we don't change it. The National Hurricane Center has a different set of names for Pacific storms. So it will go from Cesar to Douglas. It looks quite impressive on the satellite picture. We'll show you that in just a moment. I do want to show you the Mexican government has issued tropical storm watches from Puerto Madero all the way up to Acapulco. And it looks like these will be upgraded too to tropical storm warnings or maybe even hurricane watches as the storm continues to strengthen towards tomorrow morning. Let's look at that impressive satellite picture. Again, 24 hours ago it was located here in the Caribbean. It did not look this strong or this together, so to speak, on the satellite picture 24 hours ago as it does now, and calling it a tropical depression and soon to become a tropical storm, I believe is a pretty good idea. You can see the convection wrap right around the center of circulation, some very deep convection, and it looks like it's going to continue to strengthen. Now the problem here is going to be along the west coast of Mexico. Acapulco southward, all the resorts, it looks like it's going to be paralleling that coast with heavy rains, potential mudslides, strong winds, obviously. So if you're going to be vacationing down here along the west coast of Mexico the next few days, you might want to call ahead, stay tuned to the Weather Channel, call your airlines, call your travel agent just to make sure it's safe to go down to that part of Mexico. A broader scope of things, we have a weak area, let's say a weak tropical wave over the northeast Caribbean. Earlier today, there was some indicated by ship reports of some closed circulation at the surface with this strong tropical wave, but it has now showing signs of dying out. You can see it for yourself, more of a diffuse pattern of the clouds. But as it moves to the east, or towards the west, I should say, northwest the next couple of days, it will be moving under some high pressure aloft. That could help to intensify it, possibly. A big question mark. If anything intensifies and if it gets its act together, it's still a big if. It would be very slow to do so, but we'll keep our eye on it for you. Let's move off the coast of Africa. A couple of strong waves moving off the coast. Remember back on the 3rd of July what happened? Bertha was born in this part of the world. So the water's, 30 days after Bertha was born, or even warmer, so things could develop. This is the area of the world we watch for potential development. Boy, this storm looks really good as it moves out over the ocean. We'll have to watch this very carefully the next few days, so don't leave your dial. Stay tuned to the Weather Channel. Don't change your dial. Let's look at Typhoon Herb, 145-mile-an-hour winds. Looks like it will weaken as it moves towards the coast of China. Here's Taiwan. Over the next couple of days, it should lose its strength, maybe come down to around 110, 115 miles an hour as it moves inland later Tuesday night into early on Wednesday. But this is the same area of China that was hit last few days, last Thursday, with Typhoon Gloria. So we don't need any more rains in this part of China, but it looks like this is going to be another one of those flooding situations in parts of China and maybe even Taiwan. Let's right now return to the United States. So I guess we're not going to do that. I thought we had a forecast in there, but I guess we don't. If you could put in number 40 there for me, Janine, we'll check out the forecast in the Pacific region. Thank you very much. Let's go to that if we can. Gray, look at your forecast real quickly, the Pacific regional forecast. Scattered light showers in the morning from Portland, Oregon to Salt Lake City, becoming more widespread tomorrow afternoon. Temperatures in Southern California, 67 in San Diego. You'll warm up I think it was 78 would be the high there. 57 San Francisco, warming to 73. And in Seattle and Portland, around 60 in the morning, warming up to sunny skies and in the 80s in the afternoon.
Some people clean their dentures in the daytime, but if you soak at night, get new Polident Overnight. Its unique enzyme formula cleans and whitens better than daytime soaks. New Polident Overnight, next to fast-acting 5-minute Polident.
Look for a money-saving coupon for Double Action Polident in your Sunday paper.
Where's that baby?
I brought you a little something.
A little something. A little yummy.
Great, thanks.
A little giddy.
Good news for anyone who's ever eaten for two. The same medicine you keep handy for upset stomach and diarrhea also comforts indigestion.
I never knew that.
As Pepto-Bismol coats, it helps strengthen your stomach's protection against too much food and drink.
How's my baby?
Much better, thanks.
When you overdo it, take comfort in Pepto.
When you get up this early, you need real coffee. Folgers Coffee Singles. Real mountain-grown coffee in a real coffee filter for one freshly brewed cup. Folgers Coffee Singles. Because real coffee makes real good mornings.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
All right, wet travel around the upper Midwest and especially the Great Lakes. Unfortunately, if you're taking a vacation, visiting family in this part of the world, it's going to be rainy next several of days. An intense area of low pressure very slowly tracking eastward. Trough of low pressure keeping its weakness present here. Showers and thunderstorms, and we've even got rain that's getting ready to move on into the northeast. Places like New York and Philly and Boston eventually get ready for some rain. Some will be heavy, but the heaviest of the thunderstorms tonight through Kansas. As a matter of fact, we have a severe thunderstorm watch out until 6 a.m. Central Daylight Time. Possible hail here, large hail. We've had many reports this evening. Very damaging winds and even some tornadoes in some of the states to the north. Foggy travel in the morning, or as my friend Larry Duncan in Mississippi calls it, froggy travel.
At Michelin, we believe a tire that's just good in the rain isn't good enough. Introducing the Michelin X1. With a 6-year, unlimited mileage tread life warranty. It's the one tire that gives you better wet traction than any rain tire, plus control in any driving condition. After all, it hasn't rained that much in years. The Michelin X1.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Now your local forecast, and stay tuned. An in-depth look at weather in the West, Alaska, and Hawaii is next in the Pacific Update.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for tuning into the Weather Channel. I'm Brad Edwards, and behind the scenes, Greg Gentile will be punching the buttons for us in this early morning hour. Well, a lot of us are going back to work tomorrow. I'm not. I got the day off. I'm going to go to the Olympics. But I'll tell you what, we had a pretty good weekend for a lot of you. It was a cool July weekend. We'll talk about some areas that were cool, and we take you into Chicago first, and that's where they had the umbrellas out. Now, usually you think, yeah, it's raining, it's been a terrible day, but the rainfall was very, very light, and it made for a pretty nice day, a high of 75 degrees in Chicago today, and just a little bit of rainfall.